About a month ago, somebody had asked me about working up a hat in the tubular knitting. So I did up this one. It came out a little bit too tight, even though I did up the math. Some yarns are a little bit more stretchier than others. But this is the long ski mask pattern that I have on my site. So what I did was I pretty much just took that one, and even though the gauge was a little off, I did as that pattern said. But now I'm going to do more stitches. The rows were fine, it was just the width of this. But I like how the top come off, except for it is a little bit more pointy, so I'm going to do less rows up here. But to get the front and back flap so you could tuck inside a jacket to hold this hat down on you, instead of just starting out tubular, first of all, you need to work up one section of rib, and then take it off on waist yarn, and then you're going to work up a second one of rib. Actually, this is the second piece here. After you're done with the second piece, you're going to transfer the stitches from the knitter to the ribber, and then you're going to hang that first piece on the knitter. I found it easier to work it that way. And of course, I have my triangle weights on the back piece with a couple claw weights on the end. Should be good enough. If not, I'll get the hangers on the side with the small barrel weights. So now to do tubular. I do have this on P3. With tubular, it doesn't really matter, but you may want to offset it and put it to H. Now I have 50 stitches on each bed. I did work up on tension dial 2 before. I'm going to go up to 2 and 1 dot just to make those stitches a little bit larger. So now to set up the Singer type machines for tubular. What you're going to do in this case is first decide. Now if this was on the ribber, I want to knit on the knitter first and then the ribber second. So I would have to set this up. I'll set it up to do it that way anyway. So I want to knit on the knitter first. I'm going to set the cam to slip, and I'm going to take the right lever and put it forward to the circle. On the ribber carriage, I'm going to take the side lever and put it up to 0. If you remember, here is the Russell levers with the Roman numeral 1 and 2. And on the ribber, you have that same. So this is the Russell lever. This is the side lever. So now I'm all set. What's going to happen? So now I'm going to knit 68 rows. I'd rather have more around the neck on this hat than less. I want to be able to have that little part tucked down in the jacket to hold it in place. And that little extra bit around the neck may add more warmth to it anyways. So because I'm doing tubular, it's going to be 128 rows on the counter. So the easiest way I figured out on how to do the hole for the eyes is to take a contrast and color yarn and hand knit those, and I did 30 stitches. When you do this for socks, it's called the afterthought heels. But I need to get this yarn tail down below. So I'm gonna take from underneath and get my hook just to the left of that stitch and then pull it down. And that's all there is to that. Next, I need to knit for above the eyes. I'm gonna do 30 more rounds, which is gonna, well, is it 30 rounds or 30 rows? I think it was 30 rounds. So that's gonna be 60 on the counter. So just as before, just continue knitting. So now I want to decrease for the top of the hat. The easy way of doing this is just take that end stitch and move it one over on both the knitter and the ribber. But I want to go a little step further. I want to take that second stitch off, put it on the end stitch, and then put those two back. On the needle, so it's going to create that same decrease, which I'm going to do in the middle here too. So it means I'm going to have to, well, in the middle, all I do is take left two and move it over to left one, right two, move it over to right one. But I need to do it on the knitter ribber bed as well. But this is going to give that two stitches going up straight and giving you that four-point look that you would have with hand knitting. When I just took the outside stitch and moved it one in, it didn't make that same decrease look as in the center front and center back. So now, I need to move the right stitches in one and the left stitches in one. Now I found to do one stitch at a time works out a lot better because I have to turn that transfer tool or lean it away from the needles that are being decreased or going leaning towards the way that I'm moving that stitch to get it on that hook just right. Because the knitter bed is going to be knitted up next, excuse me, that time of year, I could bring those needles out to hold position and they will knit a little bit better that way anyways. So yeah, this may take you a little bit longer, but if all you want to do is just take that end stitch, move it one in, do both the knitter and the ribber, then knit two rows and continue doing that until you get about a dozen stitches left over. I'd like to get about 8 or 10 if I can. Then you're just going to do a gather bind off on those stitches. But this is going to give you that shaped crown that the hand knit hats will have. not so much with the easy machine knit hats. But it's really up to you. I know people that don't mind sitting here and transferring one stitch at a time. Just to show you real quick on the ribber stitches, I will take 3 at a time because it's so much easier that way. And then I could pull those needles out to hold. If you have a multi-prong tool, you could use that as well. Just be a little careful when you're doing this. If you drop a stitch, it may unravel on you. So I need to finish these here. I need to do the left ribber, the left knitter. When I'm done, I'm going to knit 4 rows or 2 rounds. It's going to be 4 on the counter. And do this decrease over and over and over in 4 rows in between to get the shape of the crown to come up and fit over the top of the head a lot nicer. So when you're working the double bed and you have the needles out to hold position, in this case doing tubular, it's just the knitter only, it knits those stitches a lot better than if they were in the work position. To do that on the ribber, of course, now I have to take my long metal piece here, which has a handle. You really don't need a handle on it. Pull those needles up, knit across. If you find... So now I am crocheting around the eye hole opening, making sure I go into a loop that when I take this blue yarn out, it will not unravel. I'm just doing a slip stitch, and if I happen to grab the blue yarn, I have to undo it, Let's try it again. Okay, so go into the next loop, grab the yarn from below, pull it through, and then I give a nice little tug back to kind of make it even. Go into the next loop, and I will finish that, go around, and end up in the beginning one here. Now, after you got that all done, you may have to just unravel one stitch at a time, the contrast and color yarn. But once you get to a certain point, you could just take it and pull it right through. So there, I have it all done. Now I could go ahead and even sew the middle here together so you have just the two eye openings. But look at the top. I like how that came out.